What is going on, guys? My name is Jeff. Welcome to the first video on my new YouTube channel. Today, I'm going to show you how to go from this to this. For those of you who don't know, I have an Instagram account called 7th.voyage, where I design tons of stuff in Photoshop, so go check it out. Okay, so pretty much every day, someone slides into my DMs and asks, do you have a YouTube? Are you gonna make a YouTube? Can you edit my photos for free? And every time I'm just like,
Jesus.
But being that I like to challenge myself and this is totally new for me, I decided to give it a go. So with that, let's jump into it. Today, I'm gonna teach you how to turn yourself into a Star Wars Jedi. How to Jedify yourself. Jedification. Anyways, in the video, I'm gonna cover how to add in a lightsaber, as well as how to paint highlights and some color correction. By the way, you'll need to know some basic Photoshop knowledge just to follow along. Let's get started. First, you need to grab your camera or smartphone and snap a really badass picture of yourself. Definitely not like that. More like this. Get into your best Jedi stance and act like you're holding a lightsaber. I suggest using an empty paper towel roll to get your grip right. If you don't want to use an image of yourself, find one online. I'm using this awesome photo by Facestock from DeviantArt.com. Open your image in Photoshop and begin to cut it out from its background. There's a ton of ways to do this. I like to mask mine out with my iPad. Drop it into a document that is 1920 by 1080. Or whatever size you want, that's just what I'm using. Next, find a cool background and drop it in. I use this one from Unsplash.com. Try to find one with a strong light source shining towards the camera. I then right-clicked and made it into a smart object. Then applied a field blur. Use whatever settings you want for your photo. I added about 6 points to mine. The middle one I made the blur about 35 because it's the furthest part. Then the sides I set to about 6 and the ground about 3. This just helps give us some fake depth of field and will make your Jedi stand out more. Also, I quickly masked out a lightsaber handle and placed it in her hands. Feel free to do this, or just leave the paper towel roll in your hand. Now, click and hold on the rectangle tool and create a rounded rectangle. Hit A on the keyboard to switch to the direct selection tool and grab the point close to the edge of one side. Shift it down about 5 points. And then do the same to the one right below it. Just shift it up about 5 points. This will give us a bit of a tapered look. Next, rotate the shape and line it up with the saber grip. Double-click the layer, and let's add an outer glow. I used the color white, set the blend mode to screen, and put the opacity to 100 and the size 16. Now hit Command-J to duplicate that layer, change the fill to 0, and double-click the outer glow again. This time, let's choose a color. I went with yellow, but use whatever you want. Change the blend mode to linear dodge, opacity to around 60, and the size to about 35. Duplicate it one more time. Whatever color you chose, go with a lighter shade of it, something that's a little bit closer to white. Change the blend mode to screen and bump the size to about 250. Use 100% opacity as well. This will be more of our ambient glow. You can add more layers if you want to intensify the glow, but this was fine for me. I thought my lightsaber was looking a little too thick, so I transformed it a bit just so it was a little bit thinner, re-rotated it, and got it lined up again. So, since we have this bright light behind the character, we need to darken our subject. You can do this with exposure or brightness and contrast. I use curves because, well, I like curves.
Giggity, giggity, giggity.
Drag the right point down a bit until it looks right to you. Duplicate the curves layer and apply it to the lightsaber handle by holding Alt and clicking between the two layers. Adjust that curves layer until it blends nicely. Next, let's give her some color. Again, several ways to do this. My favorite is to use selective color. Go into the neutral tab and start dragging the sliders around. Just figure out what they do. Your settings will be a bit different than mine depending on your background, but I'm going to shift the cyan, magenta, and yellow sliders so I get something that matches my scene. Now, make a new layer and set its blend mode to soft light. Let's paint in some general light. Use a soft round brush. Make sure you have pen pressure on. This is where having a graphics tablet like a Wacom or iPad is super helpful. I switch between the brush tool and the eraser tool. It's gonna help to achieve this look. Okay, it's highlight time. If you don't have the smudge tool set up as a hotkey, I recommend doing that. Choose a light color that matches your background light. Start painting on the edges of the body. Just spots where you think there could be a rim light, then use a combination of the smudge tool and the eraser tool to push and soften the highlights. This can be quite a long process depending on how many objects you need to add highlights to. I'm doing it fairly quick and dirty for the sake of time in this video, but I normally spend a good chunk of time detailing these out. And remember, if you don't like how they look, just delete them and draw them in again. Now, create a new layer and put it in overlay mode. Pick the same color as your lightsaber and start lightly painting around the arms, face, shoulders, and hair. We want this to act like light fall off from the lightsaber. I went back and forth between adding more highlights and more overlay fall off layers. Try to think about contours while you do this. What areas would catch light and what areas would diffuse it? Make sure you go around the outline of the head and add some lines to the hair to bring out some detail. Remember guys, don't overdo it. It's very easy to quickly end up with a subject that has highlights around the entire body, which normally isn't how light works. Next, move on to the face. I spent some time going over certain areas, like her ear, the bridge of the nose, her cheeks, and her forehead. I added more yellow into my overlay layer to brighten things up. I also used a small brush with the color set to white and started painting in some specular reflections in her eyes and on her lips. Again, just subtle details. We are getting close. Let's add some light blooms. I don't even know if this is what they're actually called, but that's what I call them. These are just subtle glows that would go on top of our subject. So use a soft brush, eyedrop the colors you want to use, and just gently tap them in. I made another layer in soft light and painted some more ambient light. I also repeated the same process of the highlights for the hands and the handle of the saber. I could have done them all at once, but my workflow is super sporadic and I like to build things up in layers. I'm gonna shut up for a bit and just let this turn into a speed edit for the remainder of the painting portion. The face was still a bit too dark for me, so I did one last adjustment to it. Remember the curves layer that we used to darken the subject? Paint away some of the mask on that layer with a soft brush just to lighten up the subject's face, as well as the area around her arms and shoulders. This will really help sell the lightsaber effect. Finally, let's add some smoke and do some final adjustments. You can get free smoke and fog brushes from brusheasy.com. So select all of your layers, hit Command-Shift-E so that we have a copy. Turn that layer into a smart object and go to Filter, Camera, Raw. This is where I do final color grading. I'm going to speed through this because yours will be different than mine, but just mess with settings and see what they do. I always use Camera Raw for final color grading. It's one of the most powerful tools in Photoshop to help make a cohesive image. I duplicated that layer, added a high pass filter, and put that into overlay mode, just for some extra sharpening. And that's about it. Now you're a badass Jedi. I also added some sparks afterwards for, you know, dramatic effect. Now show it to your friends and family. Tell them you're in the new Star Wars movie. All right, guys, thanks for checking out my first video. I know some things were a bit rough, like the VO levels, as well as actions not lining up with the voiceover. I'll do much better in my next one to fix that. If you like the video, give it a like and subscribe. And if you want to see more of my work, follow me on Instagram at 7th.voyage. And let me know in the comments what you want to see in my next video. Also, post your Jedi images on Instagram with the hashtag 7VJedi, and I'll feature my favorite one in my Instagram story. With that, I'll see you guys in my next video.